In this video, I'm bending plastic, riveting aluminum, and wrapping things in actual carbon fiber fabric to build a small but very capable AMD Ryzen powered system. The case is roughly 27 cm long, 21 cm high, and 17 cm wide, and the design resembles Dan case with separate CPU and GPU compartments. I started from cutting acrylic for CPU and GPU compartments. Both are the same height, but the one outlining the CPU side is a bit longer, as the CPU compartment needs to be a little larger to make room for the heatsink. After sanding down the edge a little bit, I marked bending point, sandwiched acrylic between two pieces of aluminum, and used a heat gun to warm and model the material. After making two bends, I cut off the excess of the acrylic so that both sides are more or less even and treated the edge with sanding paper. I repeated the exact same steps with the other piece, with the only difference being the location of bending points due to smaller compartment size requirements. Next, I established motherboard mounting points and drilled holes for M4 threaded inserts. Then I marked the outline of the motherboard I/O ports at the back, drilled holes in all four corners, cut the plastic with Dremel, and switched to a sanding bit to even out the edges. I decided to power the 8-core Ryzen CPU with a tiny wonder that the HD Plex power supply is. It's perfect for custom compact builds, but if you'd make the case a bit longer, you could easily find room for an SFX power supply. I marked mounting points up front and drilled holes for M3 threaded inserts, as M4 screws are too big to go through the mounting holes. Next, I marked openings for power connector assembly at the back, right above the motherboard I/O ports. I drilled two small holes on each side for M3 screws and a large one in the middle for a rather beefy power connector. After that, I established location of the opening for the PCI Express riser cable, drilled holes on each end, cut through plastic with Dremel, and evened out the edges with a smaller sanding bit. I made a corresponding cutout in the GPU section of the case using the exact same method. Next, I marked the location of the GPU I/O ports and marked two openings for the riser cable assembly and drilled holes for the M4 threaded inserts. I traced the larger cutout at the back for the GPU I/O bracket and repeated the drill to make the opening. Then I cut two pieces of square aluminum 15x15mm that will act as dividers between the CPU and GPU compartments, ensuring enough space for the PCI Express ribbon cable. I put both pieces of the acrylic with the aluminum in between into the vise, drilled holes, and riveted everything together. To make the construction stronger, I cut four pieces of angled aluminum bar, drilled a hole on each side, and fixed it to the plastic using rivets. Next, I fixed threaded inserts in all mounting points. M4 size for the motherboard and the riser cable assembly, M3 in case of the HD Plex power supply. To further stabilize the frame, I cut four more pieces of the same angled aluminum and fixed it with rivets running from the front to the back. Then I cut aluminum pipe to make riser cable and motherboard standoffs. To fix the GPU I/O bracket, I cut a small piece of angled aluminum bar, fixed it to the frame with rivets, and drilled holes for a bolt to secure the GPU in place. Right next to the power connector assembly mounting, I drilled a hole for a power switch. After that, I moved on to making side panels. I once again cut two pieces of acrylic and sanded the edges. I marked bending points and bent both panels 90 degrees. Then I cut off the excess of plastic on each panel. Next, I put the side panel in place and marked mounting points. While I was at it, I also traced the air intake cutout, drilled holes in acrylic, marked drilling points on the aluminum, drilled holes, and fixed a set of threaded inserts. I drilled holes in each corner of the air vent and cut the acrylic with Dremel. I struggled to make a long cut look presentable, so I decided to give another method a try. I used a piece of aluminum to mark a straight line and proceeded with making a groove along it using a pocket knife. When the groove was deep enough, I firmly pressed on the inner piece to break it off. Then I treated the edge with a file. Somewhat happy with the result, I took this approach when extracting acrylic on the GPU compartment panel. I drilled holes in all four corners, cut across with Dremel, and then extracted triangle pieces using the aforementioned method. After sanding down the edges, I proceeded with wrapping panels with carbon fiber fabric. It's my very first time working with carbon fiber, so I figured wrapping will be a good start. I thoroughly sanded down the surface with 120 grit sanding paper. Cleaned the surface with some isopropyl alcohol, mixed 10 grams of resin with 6 grams of hardener, and applied it onto a panel. I cut a piece of carbon fiber fabric, and after waiting 2 hours, I carefully applied it onto the panel. Next day, I cut off the excess of the fabric using utility knife and nail scissors. I wasn't happy with how the material didn't make direct contact with the acrylic, especially along some of the edges, but I hope that it will look better after applying some resin. When wrapping the outer panel, I used a different method. It involved another piece of fabric and squeezing everything together, ensuring that the carbon fiber makes good contact on the entire surface of the acrylic. It worked pretty well, but I didn't read the instructions carefully, and the result was a piece that was looking pretty good, except for places where the resin soaked through the fiber, leaving the texture of the outer fabric. I should have used more resin to soak the carbon fiber entirely and have that texture on the entire panel, and then I could sand it down. When the outer panel has dried, it didn't look as good as I was going for, so I made a decision to put another layer of carbon fiber on both panels. I sanded down some of the resin, mixed fresh batch, and applied it onto the panel. After waiting 90 or so minutes off the camera, I carefully applied the second layer of carbon on both panels. This time, the results were somewhat acceptable, and I painstakingly removed the excess of the carbon fiber material. I liked the matte finish of the raw carbon fiber, so I decided to leave it as is. I cut 2 sheets of steel mesh for the air vents and fixed them using some hot glue. Then I drilled through the resin and the panels were ready to install. I also cut a piece of a finer mesh for the top cover and drilled 4 holes to fix thread inserts to facilitate mounting points. Even though the frame is barely visible, I still decided to paint it black just to ease my OCD. 2 layers of black metal paint, finished with 2 coats of spray paint, did the trick. With everything ready, I proceeded with the final assembly. I started from threading the PCI Express ribbon cable between the 2 compartments. These are 2 generic El Cheapo cables that I've been using many times before. I eventually had to ditch them, but more on that later. The PC is built around the AMD Ryzen 1800X CPU, graciously provided by the Team Red. The processor is powered by a tiny HDBlex power supply that requires a not-so-tiny power brick. The MSI motherboard sits on a set of spacers that I made from aluminum pipe, and it's secured with a set of M4 screws. For the boot drive, I picked up the cheapest M.2 drive, 120GB WD Green. Since I'm not Linus and I don't have multiple 1080 Ti's lying around collecting dust, the graphics processing is handled by a compact GTX 1050 by Zodiac. The case performs pretty much as any other case of this size. When idling, it's rather quiet and it doesn't get much louder running Unity in Valley benchmark. It gets somewhat louder when you stress the CPU. As for the temps, the GPU is doing quite alright. Being not so power hungry, it hits 57 degrees under load. The CPU sits at a little over 40 degrees when idling, but under full load, the temp gets high pretty quick and the CPU starts thermal throttling down to around 3.3 GHz. But this is my fault, I misplaced the air vent cutout. Without the side panel, the temperature doesn't go down, but the CPU is able to turbo boost all the way to 3.7 GHz. Oh, and to get these numbers, I had to spend additional $85 for a Thermaltek Premium PCI Express riser cable, as the 2 generic cables, $5 a piece, daisy-chained, were causing major stability issues. Without the carbon fiber fabric and the obnoxiously expensive riser, the total cost of materials used for this build came to around $25, a fraction of what you have to pay for those high-end small form factor cases. The carbon fiber kit was additional $20. It would be much cheaper and easier to wrap it in vinyl, but I'm glad I went with the real thing. Maybe next time I'll fabricate a pure carbon fiber case. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.